back in a man-to-man. Drame.
Oh!
The Azotam, a no-look behind the back. Goes top of the key to Maynard. Maynard down the right side, drives and lays it in.
Anytime you...
Dobbs left side out to Starks, forces a three and hits.
That is your concern, Billy.
Starks comes left, puts it up, blocked by Hurst. First on the left side, back to the basket, spins up with the jump hook and hits.
Honestly,
Manning, Dobbs, top of the key, puts up a three. Good.
Boy, they come off of that
by Maynard. He gets it out, knocked away by Dave Johnson. He's all alone and drives and lays it in.
He looks like Brandon.
Corner Maynard. Maynard along the baseline, under the basket, right. First layup is good. Good play by Maynard.
Ouch, and all could have been.
Now down low for Drame, who dunks it with two hands.
Points today. What was going right with your offensive game today?
Just being confident. That's all it is. Being confident in the game, and the coach has been pushing it, so there's just a lot of confidence.
Bruce, you put in six offensive rebounds today and gave the team a lot of second opportunities. Talk about your work on the glass today.
I was just trying to be aggressive, just attack the backboard.
Guys, just want to talk about, you know, the role you're on. If you actually win out next week, it's only 1 week, you guys will host this whole tournament. The change that it's been and how big that would be.
It would be real good if you get a home court advantage. It would be real good. Our team is really confident right now. We're hungry and hungry. Our coach already told us that, so we're just going to keep it rolling.
But where do you guys think you'll finish this season in the NEC?
Future is bright.
We're trying to finish this. But one seed is still open right now, you know, we're like probably half a game behind after today maybe. So hopefully, you know, we just keep winning games and for the teams. Hopefully they keep losing. We want to get to the top.
Shaq, you've been scoring a lot lately. What's the reason for that?
Just my coaches just pushing me in practice, a lot of confidence. And just like I said, I'm just hungry at home.
What was the game plan going into that? You guys held a 10-point lead throughout most of the game. What was the game plan that you had?
Defense. The whole goal was just to stop them. We know they are on a very offensive-minded team, so just try to get stops and not worry about what we do offensively because that's just natural. We'll cut to us, but try to get stops.
What's your mindset when you guys come to the game? Because you guys both came off the bench today, very, very effective. Is that more challenging than being a starter, do you think? Or?
I think it helps me to feel like being a spark. You know, the opposing team is not aware of the not ready for that, so I think it helps my game.
There's less pressure on me coming off the bench than starting. Because I feel like when I start, I have to set a certain tone. But when coming off the bench, just have to just come in the game and do what I'm good at, play my game, and get us a win.
This game was a lot different from when you guys played in January. It was a lot higher score. What's changed since then?
Our defense has improved. Our shot selection, our guards are shooting better. We just got more confident because of the role we play.
An opening statement, we played a heck of a lot better defense than we did the last time we played at Bryant. I'll tell you that. I mean, we scored 103 points and shot 60%, 61% against us the last time we played at Bryant. And I hit a team that talented to 58 points and shooting 39% from the floor. It's really some numbers that I'm proud of. I thought our defensive alertness and awareness of personnel, willingness to compete and stuff was at a really good level all game. That's a team that I think has three potential first team all NEC guys. Dobbs, Francis, and Starks have had all three of them, in my opinion, had close to first team all league years. I think in the last 6 weeks, I don't know if I've been around the team that's improved as much as this team has. And just, I continue to be proud of the improvement we've made of them, buying into the message, working on their faults and their deficiencies, and just seeing the results of hard work. We have that, I reference a little shooting club that we have at night where the guards come in, take a lot of threes, mid-range shots and stuff. And, you know, I can't help but think those things help Shaq Shannon make his corner three, and Zaire Hurst make those first two jumpers, and Evan Conti makes some of his jump shots. Like Azotam has been coming as well, just working on his foul shooting. And I looked up the stats today after shoot-around before the game. He's shooting 80% from the line in like the last 11 games. He went 4-for-6 today. But so, I mean, this team works, and this team has a lot of belief right now. They're in a good place. The team still has a lot that they have to earn. But we still have a lot we have to earn. But it's fun coaching them right now because it's fun to see kids get to see the results of hard work. Questions?
Coach, three more wins in a row, and you host this tournament. As unlikely as it seems, I mean, the belief, is it just a belief in this?
It's belief and improvement, yeah. They sort of like come together. The individual improvement has been astonishing, really, of these guys. Call it growth, maturity, whatever, but it's fun. I've referenced this a couple times, the difference between UConn and Quinnipiac at that level. You think we could shut that door? Thanks. Like, I think what you're seeing is a great, that you don't see sometimes at the high major level, because sometimes the guys leave so quick, is the improvement from freshman to sophomore, sophomore to junior to senior. And I think every one of our guys right now is really improving. And if you take some time, again, like I crunched the numbers today, and if you take some time and look at the numbers of what these guys, in particular Usman, Drame, Shaq Shannon, Evan Conti, Zaire Hurst, probably the four that jumps out the most at you statistically. Since we started playing well, those four guys, their numbers have been just drastically better than they were in November and December. So, and you're talking about four kids who work hard. And so I think with the improvement and with, I kept saying, I think you've been all of our games pretty much. I kept saying, we need a win. We need a good game to happen for a couple of these guys so they can go into some other game and think, I can do this. You know, we finally strung together a couple, so now we feel pretty good about ourselves.
How's the team's confidence in the locker room?
That's sky high right now. You know, my job as the head coach is to try to always balance it. You know, we talk about having two voices in our, one in one ear and one in the other ear. You know, we want to balance being proud about what we're doing right now, because they should be proud of what they're doing right now, with a hunger and a humbleness that we still have a lot to try to earn.
I'm having a blast down here. Back up to you. Peace.
Hey, Quinnipiac Bobcat fans. This is Billy Mecca from the Bobcat Sports Network. Please join us this season at the TD Bank Sports Center for some excellent men's and women's basketball and ice hockey games. The TD Bank Sports Center is the best facility in college athletics, as it features family-friendly seating, prices, dates, and times. Please call area code 203-582-3905 or visit QuinnipiacBobcats.com to order your tickets now. Go Bobcats! Peace!